students and veterans standing proudly together at Joint Base Andrews. This celebration honors them in their commitment to carry on the memories of the nation's warriors. This is the Veterans History Project. Nathaniel Tate partnered with retired Air Force Chief Master Sergeant Cornell Langford.
I learned a lot about what it was actually like to be in that time and to actually be overseas as well.
This program, capturing this information and allowing us to tell our stories makes a big difference, because now a part of history will go on to the next generation.
And those stories are preserved here at the Library of Congress, where veterans' records are preserved and archived for public viewing.
These are the telegrams basically saying he's declared missing in action.
The American Folklife Center collects these firsthand accounts of American war veterans so that future generations may hear directly from the veterans after they're gone.
These are telegrams that he sent to his wife. This is what's called V-mail.
30 years after his service, Langford now lives in Clinton with his wife, who he met while stationed in the Philippines.
These guys, we all went in country together.
Langford never shared the story of his marriage or the many darker stories he's tried to forget.
But John Barry and I, we were really good friends.
And after a lifetime of serving, it was Tate who gave him a gift he'll never forget.
I have 5 grandkids, and I want to let them know that, you know, that you'll never forget who I am, because it's going to be a part of history.
In Washington, Leslie Spacek, CNS-TV.